Hi, everybody, it's Bonkai922. Okay, last night I was in a conversation with a bunch of people on Skype, and I couldn't get to my One Piece episode of you, and I couldn't get to my Arcana Familia episode of you. So tonight I will do them. And we'll start with One Piece. Oh my god, this episode was fucking insane. 5 out of 5 around all boards. 5 out of 5. Just fantastic, fantastic, fantastic. I love the animation in this. This animation, I can see how, you know, there are a lot of people who say that this is it's not a very good arc of One Piece. It's not very good at all. But still, I think the animation is godly in this episode. It was just freaking believable. We start off with Horty Jones. You know, Horty Jones is a scumbag. I just want to let you know that. He's like the worst villain. Him and Deccan did not live to the expectations. You know, he just is so stupid. They're so stupid. But anyway, they're squaring off, and he's saying, "Oh, you, Rawhead, you can't protect anybody." You know, and he's saying, "Oh, I will protect everybody, because that's what I've been training for the last 2 years." But anyway, we get to the fight down on Fishman Island, and there were a lot of epic moments in this episode. Just chock full of epic moments. And I'm just going to basically say crazy shit going down in One Piece this time around. His name eludes me, but I'm going to find out his name, and hopefully I can find it out, and there won't be any problems. I believe his name, let me see. The name eludes me. Well, anyway, his name eludes me. Anyway, the guy who was Sanji fighting. Yes. The imp guy, part of Deccan's crew. He's like saying, why did you hit me? He says, "Oh, because you attacked Nami. You pushed Nami over with your wind blast." And I was, and he just freaking knocks the hell out of him, and he falls down. And we go to the this episode was actually interesting because we got the full fights between, you know, the officers of the new Fishman Pirates and. The one who's, the chameleon, I forgot his name. His name eludes me. The chameleon guy, it seems like he's going to end up fighting now Brook. Because what happens is, he goes and he grabs Nami's legs. And she's like, she's freaking out because someone's got is her legs. And, the guy with the spears, he tries to attack Nami because they make a plan. Oh, I'll grab her legs and you attack her. And he ends up attacking Brook. Oh my god, that was so funny. Brook is a. I love Brook. I love Brook. I love Brook. I love Zoro. Zoro, Brook, Frankie, and Robin. Those are my four that are just. Don't get me wrong. Usopp, Chopper, Sanji, and Nami. They're pretty damn good too. But. Gotta go with those four. And he's like, "I have no... Oh, they're all dried up," he says. And he's like, "Ah!" He's freaking out and everything. And here comes Frankie. And he goes, boom! He punches this guy right in the face. And I'm like, oh my god. And then we have Usopp and Chopper. Chopper's going up against Doroma. Doroma. He's the guy with the teeth. He keeps chopping at the ground, making tunnels and shit. And Chopper, at the same time, he's got his horns and doing the same thing. He's doing the same thing, going through, making tunnels and shit and everything else in between. And this is going on. And Chopper realizes that Usopp's in trouble. So he, because this guy, that other officer with that huge freaking mallet in his hand, he's going to attack Usopp. Here comes Chopper shooting out of the freaking ground and he hits him. And I'm like, oh my God. And Usopp and Chopper are like tag teaming on this. And it seems like they've learned from their mistakes with what happened in Alabasta. So now they could fight. They were able to take care of an opponent. And they're very similar, Daruma and that other guy. Because Daruma, he goes underground, just like the other one from Alabasta. And this guy with the mallet is just like the other one from Alabasta. It's like the same kind of people with fighting styles. So what ends up happening is Usopp, when you know, Chopper gets out, he throws in a bomb, the Green Star bomb, and it just blows the hell out of it. And now, and it seems like these are the squaring offs. These are who's going to fight who. Sanji is basically going to fight that imp. Usopp's going to fight this guy with a mallet. Well, no, Usopp's going to fight Daruma. Chopper's going to fight that guy with the mallet. Brooke is going to fight the chameleon guy. You know, him, officer who goes invisible. Nami's just going to fight a bunch of people there. And Zoro, oh yes, Zoro, my man Zoro. Ah, oh, going up against an octopus. That, you remember that guy? Yeah. Awesome. Eight swords. He's like, he's got three swords. That was fucking epic. That was insane. Oh, I was bugging out. That was awesome. And then we got that. And we have also, and these are the pairings that are going to happen when they're fighting them. We also got a scene with Madame Shirley. And Charlie. She's saying she doesn't know if the island's going to be saved or not. And this old Fishman Island guy, this old Fishman guy is saying, let us pray that the princess and everyone else comes back safely. Now, like I said, the animation, oh my God, especially towards the end of this episode, was insane. Insane. Can't touch it. It's like on another level. You got to put it on a pedestal that it was so good. So what ends on happening is, Cordy is basically talking back to, you know, the Luffy and the three brothers saying, oh, you know, you're all going, you know, they don't know specifically what he's trying to do, but they realize that he took out Deccan. And the brothers are talking to each other, the other two brothers, not Fugaboshi, about it, and realize that if Deccan is unconscious or dies, the ship's going to fall. And if that happens, then Fishman Island's going to be destroyed. It's going to be completely annihilated by Noah. So they are trying to get to Shirahoshi and telling her, go the other way. Don't go up. Go sideways. But they keep getting interrupted by stupid Horty. And Horty's an idiot. I just want to say it right now. I have a complete distasteful distaste in my mouth for Horty. He's such an idiot. He's trying to be what he can't be. He's trying to be Arlong. Yeah. Why don't you take a look in the mirror, douchebag? You're not Arlong. You will never be Arlong. It's not going to happen. So you need to step it. Come on, step it. So anyway, they finally get to her and tell her to go sideways. So she goes sideways. But what happens is, while this is happening, Deccan gets up. And he's got an axe in his hand. And he's going to throw it because he touched. His right hand is the one that he keeps gloved, because that's the hand that he touched Shirahoshi with. He touched Horty with his left hand. So then he's basically getting up and he's trying to get an axe and trying to throw it, you know. And he's like, Horty, you know, and he's about to throw it. And He loses his balance, and this is all going when Luffy and Hoity Jones are going at it. And he falls on this, on the floor, hits his head on one of the, I guess, steel, on one of the, you know, beams or wood panels on the ship, and he loses consciousness. I'm like, what? And then the ship starts to fall, and everybody's like, got that shock face look. You know? And then it starts falling. And then Hoity's like, ha 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 ha! You know, I'm Hoity Jones, and I'm gonna destroy the island. Ha, 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 ha. And I'm like, hey, asshole. Just to let you know. Just to let you know. Along would never do that in a million years. Never do that. Stupid idiot. So that's basically what happened. And he got Shirahoshi crying and everybody's upset. And he got that shock face on look on their face. And I was just like, oh my God. Fantastic chapter. Did I say chapter? I mean fantastic episode. Just phenomenal animation. Phenomenal. So if anything, I can't speak for the actual manga. I can't speak for that because I didn't really read the arc, a Fishman arc in the manga. But I can't speak for the anime. And let me tell you something. Man, the One Piece anime is freaking godly. It's just, oh my God. This one was good. Like, the animation was just fantastic. And that's why I'm giving it a 5 out of 5. I'm giving it a 5 out of 5 because of what happened, and more importantly, the animation. Just a fantastic animated episode. Man. Oh, by the way, to the people who don't like One Piece and don't like the One Piece anime, what's wrong with you? Like, what's wrong with you? Like, come on, get on this, man. This is awesome. But yeah, that's pretty much what happened. My thoughts was fantastic animation. Good. I like the way things are going on. Everyone's paired off now to an enemy. They have to fight. And obviously, this is going to be over soon. This is going to be over soon. This Fishman Island arc. I'm pretty sure this probably... I'm going to get a guess and say like 5, 6 and maybe 8 episodes left. So yeah. Good shit. So yeah. It's been Bankai 922. I guess I'll see you guys later. Two more videos to do tonight. I've decided. Two more. Akana Familia. Maybe I'll do that next. And a response video. You'll see soon. It's been Bankai 922. I'll catch you guys later. Brook and Zoro for the motherfucking win. Yeah.